What's going on? I'm back. It's your boy Print, the ordinary man, the ordinary man. And yes, you like my new haircut? You like my new haircut? This the new look. This the new look. Hey, I'm on my way to El Paso, Texas, and about to spend some time with some family and going to attend a quinceañera. And I'm just like, woohoo! Some real Mexican food. Yee-hee! Yeah. Good old El Paso, Texas. Man, I haven't been here for about 3 years now. So, I just wanted to say, stay tuned because there's going to be some more information, some more good stuff. So, until then, we'll see what's going on. What's going on? I'm back. It's your boy Brent, the ordinary man, and I'm here to tell you something good. Hey, I'm back. It's your boy Brent, the ordinary man, Good morning, I'm back. Hello. What's going on? I'm back. Yes, I'm back. What's going on? It's your boy Brent, the ordinary man, where I'm informing, educating, enhancing. Yeah. How you doing, folks? Well, it's been about 2 to 3 weeks that I haven't been on air, and I just wanted to say hello. You know, I got a couple of my fans, and they were saying, Brent, I haven't seen your videos, man. You're very inspiring. You're very uplifted. And I just want to let y'all know, I've been out there grinding. I had to go to the laboratory. I got to give you some information, So let's start. First of all, I've been averaging about 2 books a month. And I think I had a video already about this awesome author named Jordan Adler. Well, he wrote this awesome book called Beach Money. And this is a powerful book. This book right here is a definitely read, because if you're in the multi-level marketing industry, Jordan Adler actually tell you his ups and downs in the business. And he has a sequel. And I actually got to read that book too, which is better than Beach Money. Now, I'm not getting paid to promote this book, but I'm just trying to help those people, you know, that's in multi-level marketing and they want to succeed. And you want to know, are you the only one, you know, not winning in the game of MLM, you know? So if you don't know who Jordan Adler is, yes, I actually got to meet him. I went to a prompting event in Houston, Texas, and I actually got to meet him. And that's Jordan right there. Yes, it is. Now, once again, in this book here, Better Than Beach Money, Jordan actually asks, you know, that he has copyright and patents to this, the information. So I can't really talk about the book, but what I can do is just tell you, it's a good read, and this one is a good read too. So that's my little commercial about books. Now, y'all probably saying, well, Brent, where have you been? What's going on? Well, I got some little treats here, man. I've been spending time with my family, and I went to attend a quinceañera. So you're going to see that today. And, you know, today, I know I'm all over the place, because I got a lot on my mind. And I am just winging this because, you know, I just think that video should be not rehearsed. It should be something from the heart and from here. So this morning I went running and I jogged probably about 3 miles. And, you know, I made a video where I was actually jogging. Well, something really happened this jog. This time when I was jogging, something happened that really provoked thought. Well, you know, first of all, you have to build up to go running. You know, you gotta, you know, get your mind right. You gotta put your your running outfit on. I put a reflector belt on sometimes, and you gotta have proper running shoes, right? So in business, you gotta have the same thing. You gotta have the, you gotta get your mind right. You have to, you know, put on dress right, and you have to have the tools to help you succeed in business. Now, let's talk about when you actually do the act of running. Well, when you start running, you gotta make sure your breath breathing right, making sure you got a nice stride and a nice tempo. Well, then you have different obstacles. You gotta avoid cars, you gotta go up terrain, down terrain, you gotta avoid puddles, you gotta avoid dogs chasing you. And so what made this run a little bit different, I was praying. I was praying for my fans. I was praying for my family. I was praying for my community. I was praying for the army. Just the military in general. I prayed for our president, the mayor. I was praying and a thought came to me. As I was running, I got chased by dogs. And you know what the first thing that happened was fear. Fear came upon me. Because I was like, hey, are these dogs going to bite me? Are they going to attack me or what? So I had to make a choice. What am I going to let these dogs attack me, or I'm going to face my fear? So, Brent, so what has this got to do with business? Well, I'm going to tell you something. The biggest problem in being a business owner, you got to deal with your fear. And most time, people are feared for the word no. They're fear that somebody is not going to like the products that they're selling. Or you're fearing that, you know, what the person is thinking of you. Well, if you want to be successful, and you got to remember, when you're running, now let me back up. I'm backing up. When you go jogging, you have to have a goal. How long are you going to run? You're going to run a mile? You're going to run 2 miles? You got to know, are you going to just run for a certain time, like 20 minutes, 30 minutes? You have to have a goal. Well, going back, and the reason why I reversed is because I had a goal to run 3 miles. So I was not going to let anything stop me from doing that. So when I came upon these dogs, I had to realize I had two options. I have a couple options. But one of the options is I can avoid the dogs or I can face my fear. And as I passed the dogs started to chase after me. And then I turned towards the dog. And when I turned towards the dogs, guess what? They went away. But when I turned my back, the dogs came after me. Isn't that crazy? So, Bryn, where are you going with this? Well, I'm going to tell you. I ran past these dogs, and I had to make a choice. Do I go another path to avoid the dogs, or do I go the same path that I run and face my fears? Wow, right? Well, I chose to go the same route and face the dog. And so I was scared. Fear came first. But you know what I noticed though? When I went back around, went up the hill, came down the hill, came around the corner, I knew where the dogs were. They were sitting, waiting for me. And guess what? They didn't come charging after me this time. They barked. They ran to the curve, but they didn't chase me. So then I thought about, I passed them twice, okay? So I thought about, Brent, what are you going to do? And I thought about business. Brent, if you go out there and face your fears, something great is going to happen. Because the blessing's right around the corner. Even though you go through these ups and downs with the hills and going down the hills, avoiding cars and everything, and then you're getting chased by a dog, Brent, go back and run again. So when I passed in a third time, guess what? A couple came out with a dog. And they had a cup of coffee and they were just smiling and they were just enjoying with their dog. And I got to notify them, say, hey, just want to let you know, the way y'all going, there's two dogs out. And your dog's on a leash. I just want to let you know, be careful. But they're little dogs. Okay? Now, if I would have chose another route, I couldn't inform that person or that couple that the dogs were loose. That's one. Number two, I was trying to challenge to face my fears because I know that in business, in order for you to succeed, you have to face the fears or the things that you're uncomfortable doing. So what is my point? My point is, if you want to be successful in business, you have to face your fears. You got to face the things that you feel uncomfortable with. And you have to remember, what is your goal? So that's it. That's the lesson today. Face your fears to achieve your goals. Goodbye.
Discipline. Hey, guess what? We got the Quinceañera.
Me quedé triste. Lloro mi corazón, me peleé con tu amor. Me peleé con tu amor. Me peleé con tu amor.